Welcome to the Daily Gerry Anderson Podcast. Lots of people sending me pieces of paper with little messages on them. Here's one that says, I was so pleased that you mentioned on your programme the names of Arthur, Mousie Brady and Jimmy Donnelly. See, the people are responding.
Are your levels all right?
Excuse me?
Are the levels all right? Emma and I aren't happy in here.
Well, you never are. No, so what's different about that?
No, but are you okay?
I'm between 4 and 5.
Oh, that's okay. Right.
I'll tell you what I do notice. There seems to be some kind of distortion in our ears. Do you find that?
No, Emma says no.
Well, why are you not happy?
Well, the first headphones that I wore were much too loud, and so were Emma's, and we've replaced them. And Emma's are a bit low now.
Uh-huh.
And we're just wondering what you're like at your end.
My end is fine. I think that Ken has been in here, sabotaging again. No, everything is okay. I was a little concerned at the start of the programme because I thought maybe perhaps there was a little distortion, which is one thing that we always try and avoid on this programme, distortion.
Like, I was just on
the fright. It's all right, but it's nice of you to be concerned about the quality of sound on the programme. It means that you care.
After a hectic day yesterday.
Yes, what a wonderful day.
I reflected on the day at home last night.
Did you?
And I marvelled at your presentation yesterday.
My presentation skills?
It was absolutely, especially your interest in sheep shearing was excellent.
Oh, you
excellent.
See,
there was obviously a lot of research went into that because the questions were just one after the other.
Ivan, you're being sarcastic.
No, I'm not. I said this guy knows about sheep shearing. He knows something about sheep.
This guy knows his sheep.
Yes. But it's obviously going back to your uncle's time.
Well,
I would say when you sheared them by hand.
I have had many lives.
And that's what I knew.
I have had many lives. My bucolic past has never let me down. Many, many years as a small child spent gambling the hills of Donegal and indeed running after keys, cows, what do you call them?
Keys.
Keys. Yes. Across between a sheep and a cow is a key.
Yes.
Running after cows and indeed sheep. And, you know, I think back in those days and I remember the things I've learnt. And I look at the children today and with their computers and their laptops and their little iPhones and I say, they're far looking. I wish I was one of them.
And your knowledge of hawks?
My knowledge of hawks is unsurpassed.
Yes.
Nobody knows any. Everything that I know about falcons should be indeed immortalised in the school curriculum. I am offering to go around schools and talk about hawks and falcons, but maybe perhaps they won't take me up on it. You see, people think I'm this kind of suave, urbane city guy, but I'm not.
And wasn't the little boy, was it Robert, the donkey boy?
But maybe he doesn't want to be called the donkey boy.
Well.
Robert Wallace, I think.
Robert Wallace is correct.
Yes. I liked him.
Yes, it's an interesting.
Do you know why I liked him? He did something that nobody else bothered to do yesterday.
He dressed up.
He dressed up for the radio.
He did.
He was wearing a lovely suit and a lovely shirt and a tie.
Yes.
Nobody else did that. You were a hangover you had.
I had not.
You had a hangover.
I had not.
That's the last time I seen you, a big bottle of water.
Yes, that's all right.
You're not a bottle of water, man. When I see you with a bottle of water, I know that you need that water. You know, you're not the type of guy that walks around with a bottle of water. So we laugh, we spit on people who laugh around a bottle. What do you think they're living? The Gobi Desert?
Do you know
this
who,
is Ireland.
Do you know who was looking at $1 million yesterday?
Me?
Not you.
Who?
And when this person walked through the crowd, it was like the Red Sea, the parting of the Red Sea. The people were moving away.
Moving away from
him. Sounds
like Jackie Fullerton.
Is exactly.
Well, you
Jackie,
see.
And Jackie was wearing a wonderful, nice suit
he's
yesterday.
He's dressed by Logan's.
Oh, it's a nice suit.
But
do you know what Jackie does?
Logan man.
Do you know what Jackie was doing for me yesterday?
I'm afraid to ask.
Jackie was doing impersonations of Jackie Fullerton.
That's easy for him to do. He can do that. But what was he saying? Was he saying things?
He was saying to me, he says, do I really talk like that? I says, yes, Jackie, you do.
You really do. Anyway, hello.
Hello, Jerry.
Oh, Geordie, where were you yesterday? That wasn't like you not to
you
show.
You never sent Geordie a pass.
Did I not? Is that the reason?
I would think so. You sent him a pass this last couple of years.
Did I?
Yes, you did.
Don't remember doing that.
Yes, you did. Because remember last year, Geordie was going to bring down the wee pony.
No, Blazer.
Blazer, bring Blazer in.
How is it, Sean?
Yeah.
How is the law for the rich and the law for the poor?
Yes, there is a law.
There's no need to make that kind of projection.
No, but you didn't send. Why did you not send Geordie his pass?
Let me just explain. Let's go back a year. Last year we wanted you to come and you wanted to bring Blazer. But then the people, there was some reason why they didn't want any animals coming in there that weren't kind of authorised or whatever it was. Would something to do with foot and mouth or something?
How did Kenny Archer allow to bring his own blondie cows?
Well, was he not a bona fide entry and all that kind of thing? No, I think you have to go through the proper channels. You can't just show up with a donkey, you know, or a horse.
I was going to have the wedding a goat.
But you see, if you had done that, that probably would have been all right. But you see, probably the idea of me saying to people there, listen, there's a man going to come along and he's going to bring Blazer. They didn't like the sound of that for some reason. It's probably all kinds of good reasons for that. They must have their rules or regulations. Otherwise, everybody would be bringing everything.
We were talking about you yesterday, Jordy, on the radio.
Mm-hmm.
We were chatting to a young boy about donkeys.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Do you remember you told us a story that you never see a donkey dying?
No, now you do.
Yeah. No, you do. That's a fact.
You never see a donkey there.
And he said, and what did he say? You never see a donkey doing something else. What's that?
Giving birth.
Giving birth.
No,
you never see a donkey.
Right.
It goes away and hides.
I had donkeys all my life.
Did you ever see a donkey giving birth?
No.
Yeah, there you are. Yeah,
that's what he said.
See, a man said he had donkeys all his life, but still, Jordy, never seen a donkey giving birth. What?
Or
did you ever give any thought as to why that should be?
When their tailboard is down.
When the tailboard is down. Did you ever see a donkey expiring? Dying?
No.
Well, you see, there you are.
Yeah. And Jerry, you know why a reason I didn't go?
What's that? I'm almost afraid to carry on with this.
He says for me.
I think you had a little visitor, had you?
What?
Had you a little visitor yesterday?
I had a wave from County Fermanagh.
What was that in English?
From County Fermanagh.
Three lovely ladies.
Three girls.
Ah, you see, you stood us up for other women.
And I brought my two duck eggs and a hen egg.
That's one way of putting it.
Away from kind of Vermont.
So these three women came to see you. Actually, why would you be coming along to talk to the likes of me when three women from Fermanagh are sitting in your house?
Because I want to see their whitewash house and half deer.
You should go down and see Hugo. He'd be very receptive to your kind of
is
crack.
He's an old one.
Yes, he is indeed. We're sorry we missed you. And there was a, you know.
Last time there, right. That's why I didn't go.
Uh-huh.
He says to me, come on, we'll have a meal. Right? And there I went.
Where
do you take me to?
Where did I take you?
The credit union.
That's not the...
That was a Labbis fair.
That was a Labbis fair. That was a Labbis fair.
And a cup of tea and now it's gone.
I said to Jordy, come with me and you shall eat like a king.
Oh, you said, come with me and we'll have a meal.
But then whilst we were going to the restaurant... Whilst we were on our way to the restaurant...
Went up into the credit union.
A man approached me and stopped me in the street and said, I am a member of the Irish trade unions and we would love you to come up...
Cup of tea and it's gone.
And he said, would you like to come up and visit us? I said, yes, certainly, my friend and I are on our way to a restaurant, but we see no reason at all we should not break our journey and come and visit the nice people who provide us with money on occasion.
Listen, there's a question for Jordy from Eileen in Newcastle. It's about her hens.
Yes.
Jordy, she says that the hen is laying a soft egg with no hard shell on it, but it's just eating everything that the other
hen. But then it's not getting enough of grit and needs out.
Tell her I'd like an omelette.
It needs out?
It's not getting enough of grit.
Oh, right. Right, but she said that it's getting the same diet as the other hens and their eggs are all right.
Well, their hen must be near done.
Eat it. Have it for breakfast.
I doubt so.
All right, then. Tell her I want a tomato omelette.
What?
All right, then, Jordy. Well,
so,
sorry,
Jerry, had you a good day?
A very good day, indeed. Sorry to say that you weren't there. We missed you grievously.
That's good, but sure, we'll have a mother's day. Oh, you come number 10.
What? Oh, yes, I know what you're talking about. You have to be quick here. That's right. I was disappointed in my placing, but what can you do? Jordy, sorry, but you'll have to come along. The next thing will be our bus run.
That's what I'm waiting on.
You keep your shirt for that.
Yes, I have a couple of clean shirts and all.
Don't wear them until then.
Yeah,
all right, then.
Care, sir.
God bless you.
Keep her, let the wee get out. Bye.
Did you knock and bar the door, I cried. We don't want them letting out and running around Belfast promising impossible things and then disappearing into rooms carving up ministries. Don't worry, said Tommy. You won't see any MLA for 4 long years. Then they'll be back saying, hello, how are you? I'm your MLA. I've did wonderful things for you. Look, you're sick and I helped you. Look. Overcome with extraordinary exuberance, I grabbed Tommy and danced in fragrancy delecto to the sound of rain-washed Welsh slates clattering down the roof. I may be standing in a hovel, but I'm staring up at the stars. I helped Stephen Nolan out of the back of a bin lorry and said, "So, it's happened again."
"Yeah," said the Ulster Goring. "Sir, I was standing on the corner trying to get a large Easter egg sideways into my mouth when I heard an uncouth, probably Catholic, voice roar, 'Mickey, grab that wheelie bin with no house number on it.' Next thing I knew, I was in the bin lorry, derriere in the air and my mouth full of fish heads. 'Tut, tut,' I said, 'You need a Gansey. A Gansey with a nuclear symbol on the front and hazardous waste written on the back.' 'Sort it,' yelled Tubby, as he sprinted off looking for a nuclear hazardous waste jumper with a 59-inch waist. 'Shouldn't be too hard to find. Surely someone out there has such a garment.'" I'm enjoying myself today. It's a pity about the listeners, though. Thank you for listening. Back tomorrow.